Well, this Easter, as we come into this year, thinking about the great I am, that there is no power, there is no struggle on this earth that can compare with the power of Jesus. Because oftentimes in our worlds, the words that kind of reign true the most, it seems like, in our lives, are words like disruption, war, pain, suffering, oppression, discouragement, sadness, loneliness. And those words are things that press in on our lives from the outside, but oftentimes those very things are welling up within us. That there's a war even going on within us of, you know, I know what's right and I want to do right, but I always end up doing the wrong thing. Or I know I'm not lonely. I know I have friends. I know I have family. But why do I feel it so much sometimes? And as we consider the power of the great I am in our lives, we see the story of Jesus of this Easter week, that just a week ago in the story, he entered in Jerusalem in celebration. Hosanna, Hosanna, the King of Kings, he's here. And they celebrated Jesus. And then just a few days later, one of his best friends betrays him. And even though Jesus wanted to do what was right, he prayed in the garden, Lord, I want to follow your will. I want to do everything that I know is to be right, and I'm going to do my best to follow and obey. Even though Jesus, that was his heart and his desire, those around him tried to keep him from doing it. Even one of his best friends, Peter, took a sword out, chopped the ear off of a soldier coming to arrest him. His friends, his family, they didn't quite understand what he was up to. Even the church of the day, the religious leaders, they thought he was the enemy. They thought he was the devil. They thought he was the deceiver. And they didn't want to have anything to do with him. They called him a blasphemer. And even the government, even the Roman government didn't care. You can see in Scripture that they probably believed Jesus, and at least they believed of his innocence. And they just said, whatever. Do you want Jesus or do you want Barabbas? I don't care. Just, okay, take Jesus, crucify him. We're out. Our hands are clean. We wash our hands of this. Even in the midst of that, Jesus remained faithful to the will of God. And Jesus offered himself on a cross, the sacrifice for our sin once and for all. The old covenant, animals were sacrificed. There was a debt of death that was required for sin. And Jesus became that debt for us. He paid that debt for us once and for all. And on the cross, that brutal story of that week of betrayal and loneliness and people trying to tempt him and say, don't do it, don't go. Jesus took that horrible story and he turned it around. And on Sunday, on Easter, his body was no longer in the tomb. And the story of horrifying brutality became a story of victory and joy and hope. And so when we think about our world, we think about our lives, we can have our story turned around as well. That's what Jesus does. In Romans chapter 5, verse 8, there's two really important words that begin this verse. But God, even in the midst of the horrible nature of what was going on, even in what we think is the worst in our lives, but God showed his great love for you by sending Jesus to die on the cross, even though we were sinners. Even when we're at our worst, Jesus looks at us and says, you know what? You are worth it. You are worth it. And he takes our story and he turns it around. And so where in our lives we see war, we have peace. In our lives where we have pain, we have healing. Where we have disruption, we have comfort. And where we feel no hope at all, Jesus brings hope. And in the midst of our loneliness and sadness, Jesus brings us joy and companionship. But God changes it all for us. And so as a church, we have said that we want to become more like Jesus in all that we do. We want to be like Jesus in every corner of our world. We want to live like Jesus. We want to love like Jesus. We want to go like Jesus. And so to do that today, the challenge to you today is let Jesus turn your story around. Your past, all of that sin nature, none of that has to define you. Jesus defines who we are. And so let Jesus turn our story around.
Thanks for tuning in to the New Hope Church podcast. If you would do us a favor and like or subscribe on your favorite platform, we would really appreciate it. Also, if you happen to have any questions, feel free to reach out to us at questions@becomehope.com. Have a great week, and know that we are praying for you as you seek to be Jesus in every corner of your world.